Have you ever needed to total a range of cells in seconds? Let me help you with the formula for total in Excel. Now, there is this amazing thing that you can do in Excel where you can get a sum total simply by selecting over cells. So watch this. If I select over this range here, down here on the status bar, you will see the sum. As easy as that. Amazing, right? I can even hold down my Ctrl key now and select other cells to add that to my total. And there we go, down there. So that's so simple. But what if we want the total displayed on our worksheet? So I'm just going to come up here and let's have a look at the sum button or the auto sum button on the home tab. So on the home tab up here, we have sum. Now one click on here and you'll see Excel lasso some adjacent cells that contain numbers. Now at this point, Excel's saying, okay, I'm going to total this range, but it's important that you always check the range. So B4 to B6, is that what you want? If it is, all you have to do is press enter. How great is that, right? Now sometimes it doesn't lasso the correct range and I'll show you how to deal with that very shortly. Okay, over here. I'm going to show you another option. Now you can also select over a range and include the cell which will hold the total. Okay, now I can give my sum button a click and it will give you the total. Look at this, if I double click into the cell, you will see that it is actually giving you the correct range and giving you the total. Now, shortcut keys. I love this shortcut key. Hold down your Alt key, press your equals key, and you will get the sum function. Press your Enter key, and there you go. All good. Now, another thing that you can do is you can hand type them. So all you have to do is press equals sum, spell it correctly, open bracket. Now, I can click and drag over the correct range that I'm wanting to total, or if you like, you can just type it. Now, you don't need to type capitals. So E4 colon E6, close my bracket. And there we go. And we now have our column totals. Right, let's repeat this for row totals. So I'm coming up here, and if I click onto the sum button, just like that, remember always check that the lasso is going around the correct range that you're wanting to total. Press your Enter key. I can also do what I showed you before, make sure that the total is going to be in the last cell that you've selected, and there we go. I can also use my Alt equals. So Alt equals is the shortcut. Now, this is what I was saying before. Sometimes Excel will lasso the incorrect range. Grab your mouse pointer, come over, select over the correct range, or as I showed you before, you could hand type it as well. Press your Enter key and you're good as gold. Okay, and another wonderful thing that you can do is you can copy. So I can come over here, this is my range here. And I'm just going to copy this using the fill button over here. So just get your mouse pointer over the little dot in the corner of the cell until you get a black cross here. Click down and drag to the right. And you have now copied that sum over into this column here. So good, right? Okay, now here's a hint from me. If you are totaling and you want to check if the total for all your rows and all your columns are exactly the same, just come out to the side here. And maybe, well, first of all, let's just check this. So this is going up. And if I come over to the side and I just do a sum, now it's going to select the incorrect range. So I'm just going to go over the range. And when I press my Enter key, look, they both match. So that's exactly what you're wanting. I don't need that now. I can just press my Delete key and get rid of it. Now let's come down here. And as I showed you before, I can click down here, go for my auto sum. Remember, you can use your Alt equals as well if you want to. Press enter. And of course, I could quickly just copy this across to get my totals. Easy. And of course, I could do the same down here. But watch this. This is fantastic. I'll just undo that again. I can select over my data and include the empty column for my total for my rows, the empty row for my totals for my columns. Now, if I do my sum, look at that. So good, right? And of course, you can go and check to make sure that your ranges are correct. Always good to check. And look, it's fine. Just like that. So clever. Okay, one last thing. Let's have a look at this. I'm going to take you back to where we started. If I come over here and I select this range here, hold down my Ctrl key, select this range here, we ended up with 2583. Now, if I wanted to have that figure up here, I'm just going to click up here, I can click onto the sum button And I can do pretty much the same thing. I'm just going to go over that range, hold down my Ctrl key, include this range. Now you can see in the sum up here, I've got two different ranges. Press my Enter key and look at that, just like that. So using Ctrl, you can easily sum different ranges within your spreadsheet. For videos on related topics, please visit my channel. For links to my courses or my weekly tips, check the description box below.